Today we will be looking into control and tools and techniques of capital expenditure control. These particular tools which are used as a means for capital expenditure limits means whenever earlier, just one day before yesterday only, we have seen that although we are investing in capital expenditure for some other purpose, for new purchase, for new venture, having loans, that also needs to be controlled by certain limits. We shouldn't cross the risk border, and for that matter we should make use of control techniques, and those control techniques are explained here. There are three main types of control techniques which are shown here. They are performance index, technical performance measurement, and post completion audit. So this is how we will go. Mohit, please, next slide. Mohit, next. Okay, thank you. Now, objectives of control of capital expenditures is to make an estimate of capital expenditure and to see that the total cash outlay is within the financial resources of the enterprise. Every enterprise is of certain size, certain strength. I mean to say their spending ability. Now, beyond that spending ability or beyond risk, they shouldn't go. This is what objective of control suggests for capital expenditure. To ensure timely cash inflow. Ensure timely cash inflow means what? Cash should come by different means. That may be sale. That may be many other types of inflows, which includes share trading or some other income source what company do have. That cash inflow has to come timely for the project, so that non-availability of cash may not be a problem in the implementation of the project. Yesterday we have seen there was plan, as an example we have seen there was a plan of a company to add two products in their product line. Now this one, as an option, they were supposed to do in-house manufacturing, outsource manufacturing, or purchasing ready-to-use product from a manufacturer. There were three options. So this is what considered as a project. And for this project, cash is required to be available within company. When cash will be available? When timely inflow of cash is happening or is getting for that company. The next objective is to ensure that all capital expenditure is properly sanctioned. This is a technical and legally bound objective. Properly sanctioned. In what sense it should be properly sanctioned? At first, it should be sanctioned by top management without prior permission of major decision makers. No company is allowed to invest in any project just because they are going well or having profit. There needs to be properly sanctioned, and this sanction, internal sanction of top management and external sanction of central government, state government, or statutory body. So this is what relevance with proper sanction of capital expenditure. To properly coordinate the projects of various departments, coordination between different departments should be there. This has to be made clear that as company is in plan to go with different types of expenditures or about to start a new project, apart from their daily routine, department-wise, they can hire extra personnel. Department-wise, they can make preparation or they can be prepared for the advance task or advance work, additional work, what they are supposed to do to fix priorities among various projects and ensure their follow-up. Priorities among various projects. Now, existing project where on companies working for last several months and running in profit is having equal importance as compared to new project. Now, it's quite possible and mentality of human being, whenever a new project for any company is about to start, then every other employee of that company is having his curiosity to look into that new project. This shouldn't hamper their existing project work. This is what relevance with fixed priorities among various projects. Which project is how much important? What return we are getting from existing project and new project? That all should be ensured and followed. To compare periodically actual expenditures with the budgeted so as to avoid any excess expenditure. Periodically, this may be monthly, quarterly, or half yearly. Expenditures on new projects, what were planned and what actually are going in. Means if project new was having budget of 10 crore for a duration of 1 year to invest that amount, and if it is going beyond 10 crore, what all are the reasons? What fluctuating factors, uncontrollable factors of market are the reason for higher expenditure than planned? This should be studied to measure the performance of the project. This is one of the most important factors. At the end of the day, whether company's employee management is working on existing project or they are looking into new project, new venture, new machine, repair and maintenance, coming up with new product, new service, that should be measured in performance, whether the performance is up to expectations or not going well. In that case, if performance in continuity for first, second, third quarter is not going well, they have to stop it. Otherwise, investing in project where no profit is seen, there's no point in investing it. The next one is to ensure that sufficient amount of capital expenditure is incurred to keep pace with the rapid technological changes. This is what technological development comes as a advances as well as disadvantage. Once a company, a software company, is outsourcing their softwares to companies which are manufacturing or having educational institute, and for their salary package or other particular products like material requirement, payroll, such things, SAP as a project is required. But what happens when they are selling their software or having tie-up with companies, they themselves have to update and give information about the advanced version. You must have seen most of the softwares, even if it is Tally, advanced version of Tally is possibly coming after every 3 months. And that advanced version needs to be informed by the software purchasers as well as seller. This communication and update is required to be made by company. Now, to prevent over expansion. Yes, in over expansion, in what sense? What happens if over expansion? Companies are going beyond their limits. One example I would like to quote here, ICFI National College, a private management institute started in 2006 in Hyderabad. They started, if you believe it, they used to have college in Jammu and Kashmir, from where Pakistan border is much nearer. And at such remote location, starting educational institute, That's true for PG level is over expansion, selecting metro cities, looking into results, then going for class A cities, then going to semi-urban area, then entering into rural area. That should be the expansion plan. All of a sudden, if you are covering entire continental country like India, your total initial investment goes very high. And over expansion is always, always having difficulty and chances of loss. Because not all parts of any country, even if we are taking example of India, are having equal potential. And in such situation, over expansion results into some part with huge loss and some parts with huge profit. Equally, at the end of the day, when total calculation is done, company is not doing well with expansion, with over expansion, to be precise. Next slide, please. Now, there are four tools of capital expenditure control. In fact, three are given, and those three are performance index, technical performance measurement, and post-completion audit. The third, fourth one, earned value method, is not included into your syllabus, but we will have it in our study for sake of our information. These three ones, which one? Performance index, technical performance measurement, and post-completion audit, three tools are capital expenditure control tools. So please go to next slide. Now, performance index, again divided into schedule performance index and cost performance index. One is relevant with time, other one is relevant with cost. What is performance index? Often it is to present information from several related necessary areas simultaneously. This is done to provide a statistical measure of how performance changes over time. And performance index is a management tool that allows multiple sets of information to be compiled into an overall measure. Now, index as a word, with your assumption or with your understanding, what it explains or what it denotes, please let me know what is meant by index for you. Any idea you can give? Yes, students, am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Index as a word, any meaning you can draw, any particular parallel word you can suggest for index as a word. What is meant by index for you?
Sir, index means a sign or means measuring something.
Yes, but index is one point.
Out yeah, of yes, is a point from where we start or it's showing the measure.
No, don't, please don't
point
have this
indicator, sir.
Yeah, performance indicator. Now what happens? From 0 to 100, if we have to measure performance, 35 or 40, even below 35, above 40, could be a number where we are having index point. Now, up to that point, if anyone is performing, means his performance is satisfactory. Okay. Above that, it is excellent, good, best, whatever you can say. But below that point, his performance is not satisfactory. That point is called as index point. Now here it is given in third sentence, Performance index is a management tool that allows multiple sets of information to be compiled into an overall measure. Performance index is a measure or one, what we say, we apply metrical scale like centimeter, millimeter, meter, kilogram. These all are applicable scales. There is one particular point, scale point. Up to that, every other set of performance has to reach. So this is what relevant to performance index. And there are two performance index in cost management: schedule performance index and cost performance index. Let us please next slide. Schedule performance index. It is the ratio of total original authorized duration versus total final project duration. Yes, schedule performance index is relevant with time. Remember, schedule performance index has relevance with time. It tells us about the efficiency of time utilized on the project. If a project was supposed to complete in 6 months, there is a sideline or line given for completion, overtime or less time, excess time or less time. Even if that particular project, instead of 6 months, is completing in 8 months, 9 months, company will accept that particular duration extra. And if it is completing in 5 months, 4.5 months, company will also accept that time. Here we are talking of time, but its relevance with profit is strongly connected. If complete project is finishing in duration of 4.5 months, that doesn't necessarily mean company is having profit. If it is running in loss, it's better completion period was 7.5 months, 8 months. Getting it? Scheduled duration, less duration, and more duration, whatever it may be, but company has to have profit from that project. The next point here in scheduled performance index is, it is a measure of progress achieved compared to the planned progress. Scheduled performance index is equal to earned value divided by planned value. Now, here I am giving you one example. Time in weeks is written and money is in dollars, $1,000. The AC here written is actual cost. EV, earned value, and PV, planned value. So here three dotted lines are given and conditions written are, if scheduled performance index is less than one, this means that more work has been completed than the planned work. Now, if scheduled performance index is less than one, that means less work has been completed than the planned one. And if scheduled performance index is equal to one, this means that work completed is equal to the planned work. So this is how scheduled performance index is calculated. Earned value is more than planned value. What happens if earned value is 1.5 and planned value is 1? 1.5 divided by 1 equals to 1.5. What happens here? Scheduled performance index is more than 1. 1.5 is more than 1. Now, if SPI is less than 1, what is meant by earned value is 0.75. Planned value was 1. Now 0.75 divided by 1 comes to 0.75. Now 0.75 is less than 1. This means the less work has been completed than the planned work. This is what relevance with scheduled performance index. Earned value has to be, which is favorable condition out of these three? Yes, students, just don't listen here. Have some participation. Now there are three conditions written, and out of these three conditions, which could be having profit to company? This is very simple question what I am asking you.
Can you please repeat, sir?
Yes, here on slide conditions are written A, B, C. You can see the slide, PowerPoint slide.
Yes, sir.
Now out of these three conditions, which condition is having profit for company? Which condition is profitable for company?
Sir, first condition.
Yes, definitely. Any other? It is written in theoretical words.
First condition, sir, right.
Even third condition, my dear friend.
Sir, third condition actually not profit. Is not neat readable.
Mohit, this third point is not been able to read by students. I can read it, but third point.
This means earning is equal to spending.
Even then it is not. Okay.
Now it is readable.
Condition CPI is equal to 1. This means earning is equal to spending. Even if earning is equal to spending, company is in profit. Because project, what was planned, is going accordingly. What was planned for project, it is going accordingly. And when company do plan according to earning profit. They are not doing charity. So, Mohit, please make it full screen. Next slide. Now, technical performance measurement. This is another performance index measurement. This is a key indicator of progress parameter or a metric that can be used to monitor the progress or performance of selected requirements. A technical performance measure is monitored to ensure that it remains within tolerances as an indicator of the progress of design. Earlier one, scheduled performance index was relevant with time. Technical performance measurement is relevant with certain values. Those values may be attained from rupee value calculation or any metric scale is applied for measurement. Now, when we are talking of mileage for a two-wheeler, very simple example I am quoting here. If 1 liter petrol at the rate of 100 rupees we are purchasing and we expect it to give us mileage of 72 kilometer, what will we say? Mileage is up to our expectations. Now, if mileage per liter petrol is less than 72 kilometer, then it is not affordable or mileage is not up to expectations. This 72 kilometer per liter is calculated and having a standard value. Many companies, while advertising their two-wheeler, they advertise this particular factor very specifically, that is mileage, apart from repair maintenance and other factors of two-wheeler advertise. So this is how relevant with technical performance measurement. Mohit, I think you missed one slide. from scheduled performance index, cost performance index was to be given. Okay, I started with next to next slide. Let's have this cost performance index. It is measure of the value of work completed compared to the actual cost spent on the project. What is here? Value of work completed. That also measured in rupee value and to the actual cost spent on the project. Okay, our budget was of 5 crore rupees for 3 months. Spent rupees are 5 crore 40 lakh. That is more than our budgeted cost, actual cost spent. It tells us about the efficiency of cost utilized on the project. Whatever amount of cost incurred on that project, and that new project may be having included transportation, manufacturing, supply, then warehouse and storage, all those things, workers' salary, tax, octroi, all these things are included in that particular project. It is a measure of cost efficiency. Now, cost performance index is equal to earned value divided by actual cost. Now, here, CPI is equal to EV divided by actual cost, earned value divided by actual cost. Now, time in duration up to 12, it may be 12 months or you can take weeks also, 12 weeks. And money amount in dollars is given here, 50,000, 1 lakh, 1.5 lakh, this is what. Now here, what it is, earned value in one and actual cost is shown in dotted lines. What conditions here depicted? If CPI is more than one, this means earning more than spending. If CPI is less than one, this means earning less than spending. And if CPI is equal to one, earning is equal to spending. The first condition is always welcome, and that denotes company is having profit from that project. So this is how conditions for cost performance index is measured. Let's assume that cost performance index has to be more than one. Then earned value, if it is 1 lakh rupees and divided by actual cost, if it is 90,000, 1 lakh divided by 90,000, how much it comes? How much it comes? Around 1.1. Now 1.1 is more than 1. So what happens here? Earning is more than spending. We can quote example by having whatever figures we want to. This particular formula, CPI is equal to EV divided by AC. You should remember, one multiple choice question could be easily and definitely asked for your annual exam. Mohit, please, next slide. Now, not technical performance, previous one. Okay. Now, technical performance measurement is second tool of capital expenditure in tools and techniques. This is a key indicator of progress and parameter or a metric that can be used to monitor the progress or performance of selected requirement. Now, different types of requirements within one project may also be measured, or entire project at one go can be measured. And this is relevant with a particular metric that is used. A technical performance measure is monitored to ensure that it remains within tolerances as an indicator of the progress of design. This could be applicable to humans also. How we can make use of technical performance measurement for human beings? We do have body mass index, BMI. When a person goes to a dietitian, physician, physiotherapists or those people who are attached to companies like Herbalife Nutrition, nutritionist, what they ask at first, please have your weight. Please let us know how much heighted you are. And based on their height and body weight, what actually they are supposed to do, whether to increase their weight or to decrease their weight, that is decided. And proportionate to height, if they do have their body weight or excess, then excess needed to be removed. This is how they work out. This technical performance measurement do have this type of metric scale. How much is required to be invested, what is return expected, and how much actually is happening. Now in body mass index, if a person is of 180 centimeter or nearly 6 feet height, his weight should be between 72 to 83 kg. Above 83 kg is not acceptable. And above, even if it is above 83 kg, it shouldn't go beyond 91 kg. Above 91 kg, it is having high risk of blood pressure and diabetes. That person may suffer in due course of time, long course of time, for arthritis, because his entire body weight is on his knees and joints. This is how body mass index is measured. Somehow, technical performance measurement is also done with this metric scale. It is one of the most commonly used systems engineering tools. Now, technical performance measurement, these measures are identified at a very early stage in the system engineering process during the conceptual design, and their progress is continually monitored throughout the acquisition phase. Now, it is a control and analysis technique that is used to project the probable performance of selected technical parameter over a period of time. There may be technical parameters relevant to design, size, shape, then movement, weight. These all things are relevant with technical parameter. Record the actual performance observed of the selected parameter. They can record on continuity for 8 working days, 22 working days, around 45 working days also, in a span of 1.5 months. Record the actual performance on daily basis for selected parameter. Through comparison of actual versus projected, manager assist the making. Performance assist the making. This is how technical performance measurement takes place. What happens? Probable performance of selected technical parameter over a period of time. This particular tool of technical performance is having metric scale figures that may be in centimeter, millimeter, meter, or specific point-wise figures in decimal points also. And they are not recorded for only one time. They are recorded for duration of 21 days. 45 days, 90 days, and this particular measurement performance for separate tools or entire machine that can be measured. And quality control department also plays an important role when finished product is tested, tried, then its performance also is measured. And this helps them to decide whether the same quality product will be accepted by end customer or it requires more and more improvements. Some additional improvements are required. This is how they are measuring technical performance. Mohit, next slide. Now, post completion audit. The third technical tool is post-completion audit. What is mentioned? An audit that takes place at the conclusion of a project. Try to understand the phase or time phase of this tool. Now, these all tools, first, second, or third. Out of these, one tool may be used or three tools at a time. Depends on nature of project could be used. So post completion audit is a tool to have capital expenditure control. An audit that takes place at the conclusion of a project requiring capital expenditure or other business initiative intended to evaluate the final cost and benefits to the company. Post completion is done at time phase when our project is complete and project what we did is taking audit and whether it requires capital expenditure or other business initiative that is intended to evaluate the final cost. Now the next point in post completion audit is they are typically performed by objective third party auditors in order to remove any inaccuracies due to bias or preference. Now here, what bias or partiality is having chance when I am as an individual or I am along with my team working on a project given to me by my own company. I worked on it. I did my well. I am feeling so. And if post completion audit is also given to me, why I will give any negative remark? What company will say? It's you who took responsibility of doing this project. And now you are saying this project is not up to the mark, not up to the expectation. How could you do this? So this is what the third party is necessary here. Post completion audit is done by third party. Whether it is post completion audit or any other type of audit, it is never done by internally when it is required to be done without any bias, without any partiality. You must have seen chartered accountants once in a year come for financial audit of organization that may be any other type of organization, that may be educational institute, that may be manufacturing unit, that may be tourism or hospitality industry like restaurant, hotels, likewise. And they go for impartial, unbiased audit because they don't have anything to do with profit and loss of that company. They go straight away with the legality and complete their audit process. Now, post-completion auditing of capital investments is a formal process that checks the outcomes of individual investment project after the initial investment is completed and the project is operational. After completion of individual investment and initial investment project, when becomes operational, that post-completion audit is done. When the project is ready for service, ready to be used, and ready to serve end buyers, end consumers, that audit is done. If the project completed is having satisfactory results, this project in continuity in future will have profit for company or not. Whatever investment was done according to predictions made, if the same amount of investment is been utilized or more amount is used, that is also checked. Now, one Commonwealth game event was held in India and MP from Pune, Mr. Suresh Kalmadi, was having charge of Commonwealth game. What happened? This is not the point of post-completion audit. After completion of those Commonwealth game, a huge fraud was detected. For that event of Commonwealth game, first day and last day, balloons purchased were of 1600 crore rupees. Can we imagine if we have to purchase balloons of 1600 crore rupees, how much quantity of balloons may come? As such, Commonwealth Games agreed it is a world event, world known event, and India was host for that event. But that had expenditures beyond anyone's wild imagination. After audit, government came to know that there is a fraud, and main culprit was Mr. Suresh Kalmadi. So this is what happens after completion of audit, whether it is post completion audit in case of capital expenditure budget or capital expenditure control, or in that case any other type of audit. It is an objective and independent appraisal of the measure of the success of a capital expenditure project in progressing the business as planned. Now, what is the objective of audit? Independent appraisal of the measure of success. If the project has successfully completed according to budgets and revenue is getting generated, it is an appraisal of capital expenditure, and if it is happening according to business as planned. The appraisal should cover the implementation of the project from authorization to commissioning and its technical and commercial performance after commissioning. Once the project is completed, in management language, is business language, its commissioning happens, means what? It starts working for end buyers. It starts giving its output. It starts manufacturing the projected product line or services. If a star hotel has to start serving its customer, 5-star hotel, 3-star hotel, till post completion audit, customers or travelers are not allowed to book their rooms. Customers are not allowed to make use of that 3-star hotel. Now that 3-star hotel will have post completion audit. And if that audit is stating that whatever was budget planned, based on that budget only, all the things are completed. Now, even if that budget is exceeded, it has a certain limit. It's quite possible that a mega project takes place and it takes 3 to 5 years for completion. In case of metro lines to be started, metro work, we have started around 7-8 years back. And those days, what was value of 100 rupees? It is not today. And as such, metro completion or metro project itself requires 1,000 crores of rupees investment. Now, if that time 13,500 crore or 8,000 crore rupees was the tentative budget for completion of that project, after 5 years, 8,000 crore rupees of before 5 years is not having that money value for today's date. It is much lesser than 8,000 crore. So when actual budget implementation and completion of work happens, budgeted rupee value goes above the total investment, or the total expenditures goes much above than 8,000 crore. And that is also declared by company. They are not hiding it, whatever comes above 8,000. So this is what relevant with post-completion audit. The information provided is also used by management as feedback. Information provided in post-completion audit is also used by management as feedback. And how this feedback helps management when they are calculating total investment for a project, they have to calculate break-even point. They have to decide final price for their product or service. They have to decide how much cash inflow will come to them, and if projected value of a particular project is getting recovered in certain duration or not, and this feedback helps them to decide project's value and product or service value. This is how post completion audit helps in control of capital expenditure. Please next slide. Now this fourth tool or technique is not mentioned in your syllabus, but we will cover it. Earned value management. Earned value management is a project management or project or performance technique, and performance and progress in an for measuring project objective manner. Now earned value management is a project management technique for measuring project performance and progress. It has the ability to combine measurements of the project management triangle. What triangle it has? Scope, time, and cost. Earned value method has relevance with scope, time, and cost. Now, in further explanation, what is stated here? In a single integrated system, EVM is able to provide accurate forecasts of project performance problems, which is an important contribution for project management. Now, if a company is coming up after thorough research in garment with one new type of cloth, and they do believe, apart from terricot, cotton, terrylene, or any other type of material used for garments, this particular material completely new and patented or not patented will be accepted by market very quickly, and especially in urban area, we will have major benefit. What happens? This earned value method provide accurate forecast. Really, your garment will work out, will make you profit, or will have some problem. Apart from other existing types of clothes or types of cloth material, new one arrived in its introduction, growth, or maturity. Maturity is as a sign we will think of later. But as a newly launched product, you think if you are the only seller or maker of that particular cloth material, definitely you will have scope, because you will have less competitors. Young generation is always interested in different types of new cloth material. Combination of different cloth materials made by chemical or by textile engineering. So this is how relevance with scope. When a product is having scope, if it is patented, if it is absolutely new, if competition is less, and if it is launched at one time throughout the country, throughout the world. Now the time as a factor considered here, early earned value method research, early EVM research showed that the areas of planning and control are significantly impacted by its use. And similarly, using the methodology improves both scope definition as well as the analysis of overall project performance. Planning and control, this is what relevance with EVM. And next point, EVM implementation for large or complex projects include many more features such as indicators and forecast of cost performance over budget or under budget, and schedule performance behind schedule or ahead of schedule. This is what relevant with time. Now, time as a factor is very much important. We have seen that when our own
two labs from India were engaged and manufacturing Covaxin and Covishield. Other countries like America and European countries with much less population booked their vaccine much earlier than India and in higher quantity than India. Their vaccination program is running smoothly because they consider time as a factor very intelligently. How America as a country is now having in possession, having in stock 70 crore vaccines. This much vaccines are not even produced in India. Why they booked their vaccines in month of September only? We started our booking in month of January. That's too much less quantity. That's the reason our vaccination program at some centers, it remains closed for 2 days and starts again on third day. At some centers, it is remain open today and don't know whether it will remain open tomorrow. This is shortfall of vaccine happening throughout India in all major cities also. Mumbai having very high demand. In last 15 days or 1 month, they have opened global tender. This is not the time when they have to open global tender. These all things must have been done much earlier to vaccines launch. Because other countries like Europe or America, they have booked their vaccines much earlier. So this as a time factor is very crucial. Next slide. Okay, so these were the four methods of time, cost, and scope. Now, with these four methods, only three methods